Welcome back to my stand-up channel. Step 4 of Boris Johnson's lockdown roadmap will be delayed until July 19th in England. But there are some changes for weddings, wakes and care homes. Here's what you can and can't do from next week. Boris Johnson has dashed the hopes of lockdown-weary Brits by extending England's restrictions for 4 weeks to July 19th. England will remain at Step 3 of the PM's roadmap. Limiting indoor parties to 6 people and meaning nightclubs must stay shut. Masks will continue in shops and on public transport. Work from home guidance will carry on, and table service remains in pubs. But thousands of couples will get a reprieve, as weddings and receptions will be allowed to go ahead with more than 30 attendees. Rules on wakes and care home visits will also be relaxed slightly from next Monday. Meanwhile, vital reviews spelling out future rules around social distancing and COVID passports have not materialized. Both reviews have been delayed and will be published ahead of July 19th. The Prime Minister took the decision after scientists warned pushing ahead risked a surge in hospital cases as bad as the first wave last April. He said he was so concerned that the Delta strain was spreading faster than the third wave predicted in the February roadmap. Back then, scientists had predicted more than 30,000 further COVID deaths between February 2021 and summer 2022. But the government has now received advice that the Delta, Indian, variant is between 40% and 80% more transmissible than the Alpha, Kent, strain, much higher than first thought. The PM said if June 21st went ahead, there is a real possibility that the virus will outrun the vaccines and thousands more deaths would ensue that could otherwise have been avoided. He added, "It's unmistakably clear the vaccines are working and the sheer scale of the vaccine rollout has made our position incomparably better than in previous waves. But now is the time to ease off the accelerator. Because by being cautious now we have the chance in the next 4 weeks to save many thousands of lives by vaccinating millions more people. 2 of the 4 tests to move to step 4 are not met. Variants changing the risks. And the risk of a surge in hospitalizations which would put unsustainable pressure on the NHS. There will be a 2-week review of the delay on June 28th. And the PM's official spokesman said if data is much better than expected, restrictions could then be eased on Monday, the 5th of July. But the spokesman added this outcome is unlikely. There is no guarantee step 4 will not be delayed again, and the move to step 4 will only be confirmed on July 12th. But Boris Johnson said, "I'm pretty confident that July 19th will be a terminus date." And his spokesman said there's no suggestion of reversing restrictions and crashing back into step 2. So what can and can't you do from next Monday in England? Here's a rough guide. You can get a vaccine earlier. The government has officially brought forward its July 31st target to offer a first dose of vaccine to all over 18s in the England. Instead, it now aims to offer all adults a first dose of the vaccine by July 19th. The new date step 4 should take effect. At the same time, ministers have set a new target to offer all eligible over 40s in England their second dose by July 19th at the latest. To achieve this, all over 40s will now be offered their second dose 8 weeks after their first, not 12 weeks, as is the case now. The dose interval had already been shortened for over 50s. But it will now be shortened for people in their 40s as well. Number 10 said people in their 40s will be contacted to change their appointment date for their second dose. So they do not need to contact the NHS or their GP themselves. These changes should mean 2/3 of adults have been offered both doses by July 19th. Meanwhile, the government is looking at whether the changing balance of risk could mean the AstraZeneca jab is once again offered to younger people. Currently, it is limited to over 40s due to the small risk of blood clots, but as COVID cases rise, the benefits of getting the jab will be more likely to outweigh any risks. You can get married with number 30 person limit. The 30 person limit on weddings will be removed in England from June 21st, despite step 4 being delayed. That means there will be no numerical limit on either receptions or ceremonies, either indoors or outdoors. Instead, capacity limits will be the highest number of people venues can accommodate while still being COVID secure. The 30-person limit will also be lifted on weddings outdoors on private land, including in gardens. There will be a risk assessment which organizers need to fill out. It will mean weddings with hundreds of people can go ahead after months of uncertainty. But other restrictions on weddings, including the ban on most singing and dancing, and guests having to wear masks at certain points, will remain in place until step 4. People at an indoor venue will need to be on tables of no more than 6 people. Indoor venues must shut off their dance floors, apart from for the first dance. Marquees on private land need to have 2 sides open to qualify as outdoors. The rule of 6 indoors still applies to weddings in private homes, except for deathbed weddings, which can have up to 30 guests. You can attend a loved one's wake, not just their funeral. The 30-person limit on other commemorative events, including wakes, will be lifted in England from June 21st. Instead, capacity will be driven by the maximum number of people a venue can accommodate within COVID-secure rules. This means wakes will now follow the same capacity rules as funerals. You can have a relative from a care home round for lunch. Rules on visits outside care homes will be relaxed in England from June 21st, despite the delay to other easings of lockdown. The PM's spokesman said, the requirement for residents to isolate for 14 days after visits out of care homes will also be removed in most cases. From June 21st, care residents won't have to isolate after spending time away from the home with family and friends, including overnight stays. And residents will no longer have to isolate when they're first admitted to a home. Instead, they'll take a series of tests over the first 2 weeks to allow for a less disruptive introduction to their new home. But they will still have to isolate for 14 days following hospital visits. Fuller guidance is due to be published by the Department of Health and Social Care. You can still meet up to 29 friends outdoors. Step 3 already allows outdoor gatherings of up to 30 people. While social distancing recommendations still apply, they are not the law. And people are able to use their individual judgment. For instance, an outdoor gathering between 2 fully vaccinated people is safer than an enclosed area with people who only had 1 dose. Boris Johnson suggested people may wish to continue social distancing after July 19. The Prime Minister said, people may want to keep maintaining social distancing. They may want to keep being sensible. But as far as I can see, we will be in a much better position as a country to go forward with the full opening up that we envisage. You can still attend school without a mask. There are no plans to reintroduce masks in schools, though there is an element of local decision making based on cases in their area. Local authorities retain the ability to change their approach in areas where there are SIG outbreaks, but we're confident our guidelines are the right approach, said number 10. You can't have more than 5 friends round indoors. The biggest restriction still on people's lives in England is arguably the rule of 6 on indoor gatherings. People cannot legally gather in groups of more than 6 people, or a larger number of people from a maximum of 2 households. As long as you're within the rule of 6, you can have people round for overnight stays and make your own decisions on hugging. But the 6-person cap has prevented house parties, big Sunday meals and nightclubs, more below. There are exemptions for work, education and some, COVID-secure, events. Axing this rule of 6 was a key part of moving to step 4, so that means the indoor rule of 6 remains for now. You can't all head back to the office. Advice to work from home where possible will continue to apply after June 21st, due to the delay to step 4. You can't rip your mask off. General laws on masks in shops and on public transport remain in place, and are not being lifted from June 21st. Those who fail to wear a mask without a medical or similar exemption can be fined £200. You can't go to a nightclub or strip club. Nightclubs are among the only venues still shut under the step 3 of the government's roadmap for England. It's been a brutal 15 months for these venues in which they have not been able to open at all, even last summer. Also shut are dance halls, discotheques, sexual entertainment venues and hostess bars. The aim was to allow these to reopen at step 4 of the roadmap, potentially with COVID passports. But that's now delayed. You can't pack out a football stadium. Currently, most large events can only operate at 50% capacity or less, making sports fixtures and gigs difficult to turn a profit or be fun. Since April, there have been pilot events, trialing the idea of packing in large crowds without social distancing. Attendees have taken rapid COVID tests before they're allowed through the gates. In a model that could potentially be used as a return to normality. But this return will have to wait. Instead of forging ahead, the government plans to hold more pilot events to get more data. You can't claim more furlough. There are no changes to the furlough scheme or other economic support despite the 4-week delay, the PM spokesman said. That includes no change to the ban on commercial evictions, which is still due to end on June 30th. Currently, the government is paying 80% of wages up to £2,500 a month as part of the coronavirus job retention scheme. From July, government contributions will fall to 70% up to £2,187.50. With employers having to pay 10%. They then fall again to 60% up to £1,875 in August and September, with employers paying 20% before ending altogether. Number 10 refused to accept modeling, which has claimed the delay could have a £3 billion impact on the hospitality industry. The PM's official spokesman said, as you would expect, there will be an economic impact to further delay. At the budget, we deliberately extended most support well into the autumn, acknowledging there could be uncertainty in the path of the virus. Source: mirror.co.uk. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.